As the Dean of the Maryland Congressional Delegation, it is my honor today to welcome the House's newest member, Representative Kwesi Mfumi. However, he is not new to the House. He is a veteran of this body, a skilled and experienced legislator who represented Maryland's 7th District from 1987 to 1996. When he left to become the national president of the NAACP, Elijah Cummings was chosen to succeed Mr. Mfumi. Now, as we continue to mourn Elijah's passing, we welcome Representative Mfumi back to his old seat to carry on the work that he and Elijah have both been engaged in for many, many years. The voters of the 7th District, to their credit, replaced great intellect with great intellect, a passion for justice, equality, and opportunity, with a successor who mirrors and shares that passion and history of commitment. Their shared work has been to ensure that the promise of America is kept for all Americans equally, regardless of race, or faith, or gender, or sexual orientation, or national origin. To break down disparities in justice and access to opportunity, to address the tragic and unacceptable disparities in access to quality, affordable health care, which the COVID-19 tragedy has made so starkly evident. To make certain that every child in this country can go to a good, safe, public school and receive a quality education that leads to a rewarding career. That's what Representative Mfumi fought for as a member of Baltimore City Council and as a member of this House. It's what he worked hard to achieve as a former chairman of the Congressional Black Caucus and as the NAACP National President. I speak on behalf of our delegation, but all those who serve with him here in the Congress of the United States, we are pleased that he is back with us. And I know that those who were not members when he last served will find him to be a wonderful colleague, a man of wisdom, thoughtfulness, depth, and whose experience can help guide this House and our majority as we navigate challenges both longstanding and new. I hope that all of my colleagues will join me in congratulating Representative Mfumi on his election to represent Maryland's 7th Congressional District once more, and in welcoming him back to the House. I am now honored, Madam Speaker, to yield to my friend of longstanding, my colleague, my fellow Marylander, Kwesi Mfumi.
Thank you very much, Mr. Majority Leader. I appreciate your kind and overly gracious remarks. Madam Speaker, I rise to offer my heartfelt thanks and my deepest appreciation to the people of Maryland's 7th Congressional District for the high honor and the distinct privilege of again representing them here in the Congress of the United States. I'm happy to have been joined by members of our distinguished delegation from the state of Maryland, and I appreciate their presence here among us. I thank Almighty God for the victory and for my wonderful family and friends. I'm joined here in the gallery by my wife, Dr. Tiffany Beth Mfumi, and a longtime family friend, attorney Eric Bryant, and others. I'm honored by those supporters who are Black and white, Latino and Asian, who could not be here at this time, but who have worked so very hard to make sure that this moment would be possible. And I believe, as they do and as we continue to do, that racism, sexism, and anti-Semitism are wrong, that Black bigotry can be just as cruel and evil as white bigotry, and that gay bashing, immigrant bashing, and union bashing ultimately deplete us as a nation and rob us of our ability to make true and lasting change. Today marks my return to this body after 24 years. And following the death of the Honorable Elijah Cummings, my friend of 42 years. I do so against the backdrop of COVID-19 and in the midst of our nation's greatest health crises of the 21st century. Simultaneously, we're also locked in the nation's greatest economic collapse, where there are now families and individuals who haven't had a paycheck in weeks as they struggle to buy food and to pay bills. Madam Speaker, our challenges as a nation at this hour, as you and others know better than I, are economic, educational, social, and systemic, and they require both the courage of conviction and the unwavering resolve that the American spirit has always exhibited in order to solve them. Thus, in yielding back my time, I call forth the words of Dr. Chang Cheek when he so eloquently exclaimed, "I have not given up on the American idea or on the American possibility, and I ask my colleagues in this body not to give up also. I'm convinced that our nation still stands before the world as perhaps the last expression of a possibility of mankind, devising a social order where justice is the supreme ruler and law is but its instrument, where freedom is the dominant creed and order but its principle, where equity is the common practice and fraternity the true human condition. It is against that backdrop that I welcome and embrace both this challenge and opportunity before me." Madam Speaker, I thank you, and I thank the distinguished Majority Leader for his words of introduction, and I yield back the balance of my time. Thank you.
Thank you. Under Clause 5D of Rule 20, the Chair announces to the House that in light of the administration of the oath to the gentleman from Maryland, the whole House number is now 430. Pursuant to Section 7B of the House Resolution 891, the House stands adjourned until 10 a.m. on Friday, May 8th, 2020.